Someone asked me my view of Roger Goodell and his newfound respect and love for Colin Kaepernick. Asked me whether or not I agreed with what Roger Goodell was doing right now. So Roger Goodell, just to catch you up, basically said that, quote, he wishes that he had listened sooner to Kaepernick, Colin Kaepernick. That's what we should have listened. That's where we should have listened sooner, Goodell said. That's where we should have been in there with them, understanding and figuring out what we can do as the NFL. He was talking about that he did not properly respect or understand the kneeling. Roger Goodell, on August, what's the day, Coca? On August 24th, with everything that's gone down, with all of the systemic racism, social injustice, all of the water under the bridge with Kaepernick and him being absolutely blackballed and not signed, whether it's because of his talent, not being good in the clubhouse, or the fact that he was drawing attention to a social issue that was very not well received by owners or by the president. But then more and more people got murdered. More and more people started speaking up. More and more people realized that this has to end now. And all of a sudden the NFL grabbed onto the coattails of justice and said, we are going to be the leaders now. During their draft, every time, every moment they have talked about how woke they are and how on the program they are. But now Roger Goodell has gone one step further and said, yeah, we should have listened to him. We should have known that it wasn't about the flag or about the veterans. This was about bringing attention to injustices in the black community and everywhere else. You're a little late on this, Roger. What is making you do this? Oh, are you doing this because the players are still holding you accountable for your actions? Are you doing this because you want to make sure that in Washington and in political circles and with everything that went on with the Washington football team and with everything that's still going on in this country and in this world, that you continue to be on the right side of history? Well, what's the playbook for being on the right side of history? Do you know how to be on the right side of history? By being on the right side every day. Because history, by definition, judges you in the past tense. You can't plan to be on the right side of history. You just have to do what's right. And if you do what's right every day, by definition, you'll always be on the right side of history. But when you become a person who is reactive and not proactive, and tries to pretend that you cared about something the whole time when you didn't, when you are a public figure where there is absolute proof of what mattered to you and what didn't, and then you try to rewrite the narrative to change your legacy, to change your history, you have forgotten the basic principle of legacy, that you are writing more and more of it every single day. Now, it's not that Roger isn't trying. I mean, he just sent an email to his entire staff in the NFL today, saying earlier this month, I had an opportunity to sit down with the NFL legend, Emmanuel Acho, for his series, quote, Uncomfortable Conversations with a Black Man. We had a lengthy, in-depth discussion about race, and it was very informative. Part one of the two-part episode premiered on YouTube, on his YouTube channel last night. You can watch it here with a link. Part two drops tonight. We'll pass that along after it does. We covered a lot of ground during our session, but it's an important topic and one that deserves our attention, both at the league and throughout our society. I encourage you to watch and send me any thoughts you may have. All right, I'm sending you my thoughts, Roger, and I haven't watched it yet. My thoughts are, it's really nice what you're doing. But an acknowledgement that the reason why you're doing these things, it's okay to say that you've changed. People evolve. People see the error of the ways. I want to believe that people can change for the better. I want to believe that they can change their future while acknowledging their past. I want to believe that people can act differently in the present. But in order to do it, you have to gain trust and you have to gain credibility. And the way you do that is by being honest with your constituents. Don't tell me that earlier this month you had an opportunity. Were you so busy the past 10 years that you didn't have a half hour or an hour or 2 hours or 4 hours or 30 minutes? You didn't do it because you didn't have to do it. And you now realize that you have to do it. As a consequentialist, I'm in. I'm glad it's being done. But don't for 1 minute tell me that that isn't about business. This is nothing personal.